Gurganeshabhyam Namaha. At the time of creation, the tattvas, the components of the universe, they themselves praise the greatness of Lord Ganesha with a beautiful stotra. It is called Tattvakrata Ganesha Stuti. Namaste Vakratundaya Bhakta Samrakshakaya cha Sarvadhishaya Sarvaya Gananam Pataye Namaha. Why is Lord Ganesha called Vakratunda? Simply put, he has a tunda that is vakra, a trunk that is curved. Lord Ganesha's trunk is always curved, either to the right or left. You will hardly find Lord Ganesha with a straight trunk. But why is his trunk curved? Vakratunda has two components, vakra and tunda. Vakratva is crookedness, and tunda means to break. Tundayati. Tundayati means to break. To smash the crookedness of Maya with something as strong as his trunk. So, Lord Ganesha smashes crookedness of Maya with his trunk, and his devotee gets realization of truth with his help, as he smashes the influence of Maya on his devotee with his trunk. Vakratva also has another meaning. To be straight means to follow something as it is, to take Maya for real. To be curved means to be different, not to take what you see and hear as it is, not to accept the unreal world as it is, to think about it in a different way, so that you understand it correctly. So the Lord, as protector of his bhakta, bhakta samrakshaka, through his curved trunk, is telling that Maya is crooked and it should be smashed. It is possible by understanding its ways and not by following it as it is. He is Sarvadhisha, Lord of everything. He is Sarva. Being Parabrahma, he is everything. Everything is just different forms of him. And he is Gananampati, Lord of groups. Gana means group. Lord of Devas as a group. Lord of Indriyas as a group. Lord of groups of people, like villages, countries. Lord of groups of trees, groups of birds, groups of animals. Lord of the group of Bhutas, the Panchabhutas. Wherever you see multiple, wherever you see numbers, groups, you should see his presence there as their Lord. Avyakta vyakta rupaya satya satyaya te namaha samaya vishamaya iva vighneshaya namo namaha. Avyakta and vyakta, these are the two states of Parabrahma, Paramatma. What we see around us now as the universe is the vyakta rupa. But after pralaya, all these won't be there. Everything will be withdrawn back, and what will exist after pralaya will be single, uniform, homogeneous matter, which itself is Parabrahma. This state is called the avyakta state. Then again, after some time, creation happens, and the avyakta transforms itself into vyakta. Both the states, avyakta and vyakta, are Lord Ganesha only, because he is Parabrahma, Paramatma. Shastra considers the avyakta state as real, satya. That is the base state. What we see today as universe is only there for some time. It is like waves that rise up from the sea, which again fall back into the sea and disappear. But the sea is there forever. So the avyakta state is considered as satya, permanent, and the vyakta state, as we see and experience around us now, is asatya. But both satya and asatya are Lord Ganesha only. If satya is Lord Ganesha, then asatya is also Lord Ganesha. There can't be anything other than him. Both sama and vishama, odd and even, are him only. In astronomy, zodiac or space is divided into 12 signs or rashis. Half of them, Mesha, Mithuna, Simha, Tula, Dhanus and Kumbha, are called samarashis. And the rest, Vrishabha, Karka, Kanya, Vrishika, Makara and Meena, are called Vishama Rashis. Both Sama and Vishama Rashis. That means the entire space is him only, filled with him only. And he is Vighnesha. Vighnas, obstacles are under his control. He can create and remove obstacles.
Yajna Rishra Padamal Karma.